So welcome back to Midpoint, co-founder and president of Bronstein and Weaver, where he plies his trade as a Democratic strategist. Michael Bronstein joins us again. All right, Mike, I'm going to go ahead and throw a couple of issues at you here, and let's get the left side of strategy for all of this that's going on right now. First of all, the Keystone Pipeline, the Democratic-controlled Senate is going to get a chance to vote on this. The House has already passed it. Everybody on the right says this has got to go. It's jobs, it's money, and it's foolish if anybody turns this down. What are the Democrats going to do now? And do you think that the Senate will pass it?
Democrats have split positions on this. There have definitely been a number of Democrats that voted that broke party rank and voted for the bill. I think that it's going to be hard as it passes through the Senate to categorize this as a one-party deal. I do believe that this bill will pass through the Senate. I think it'll wind up on the president's desk, and the president has made motions that he's going to veto it. Most Democrats who are in, I mean, you've seen Mary Landrieu, she's come out in support of this bill. I think that most Democrats who are in the Midwest will be looking at this bill pretty hard, and those who are more moderate have been very interested in passing this bill.
Do you expect the president to veto it as promised?
I do expect the president to veto it as promised. I don't know if it's going to be dead on arrival. I think there are going to be a lot of conversations that are going to happen between now and then. There's certainly supporters that are in these states that want to see a job creation and are talking about this primarily as a jobs bill. And I think that becomes quite a problematic argument when you start arguing about arguing jobs versus environmental protection, especially given the way people feel about the economy right now.
Let's go ahead and move over to immigration amnesty. The president, of course, says he's going ahead, hell or high water. He's going to issue his executive action right now. There are some outlets reporting that the Republicans are willing to shut down the government. However, in a lot of printed reports today, many Republicans say that is not what we are going to do. From a strategic standpoint, what do you expect the Democratic leadership to do to try and blunt this in any way they possibly can? Certainly the president is going to do what he can.
Yeah, I think that Democratic leadership is very much for what the president is going to do. It looked like that there might be some type of compromise, some type of agreement just a couple of years back on this issue, if you recall. But right now, it seems that the parties are very intractable when it comes to their positions on immigration. So what's going to happen is the president is going to issue an executive order. Likely what that will do is it'll be limited, I think more limited in scope than what you're going to see the media rumbling about. There'll be a lot of talk about it, but even under the executive order, the legal ramifications are going to be limited as to what the president can actually do, and I suspect only temporary, because with an executive order, the next administration could very much turn it down. They could overturn it, and you know that basically puts anything on the table, considering that there won't be a law passed on this anytime soon.
Do you believe Republicans will back up on their promise and actually shut down the government?
I think that there's a switch hiding out somewhere behind Mitch McConnell's desk where he can just basically turn the switch off on government or unplug it, and these guys are ready, and they're ready to make the threat, but they're also ready to pull the plug.
All right, 30 seconds left. Obamacare, what do you expect the Democratic strategy will be as Republicans, again, they are fully committed to repealing this bill?
Yeah, the Democratic strategy is going to be to try to ringwall this law. And Republicans, if you've heard, they've said that they're going to tear at it root and branch. And so as Republicans start to get out their chainsaw and look at chopping up the law, Democrats are going to do everything that they can to make sure that that Republicans aren't able to cut this up into shreds. There's going to be an interesting court challenge that's going to happen over this, and the Supreme Court will probably get to take another look at it. And Democrats are going to do all they can to make sure that this signature law stays in place.
And the battle is joined. Michael Bronstein, a pleasure to have you on the show, my friend. We'll look forward to the next time.
Thanks so much.
All right, our pleasure. Coming up next, Telling It Like It Is deals with one specific issue on one specific day and one specific song. How many of you know the song Fortunate Son, done by John Fogerty and Creedence Clearwater Revival? How many of you saw it performed at a veterans concert last week by Bruce Springsteen and a few others? How many of you knee-jerked? And how many of you didn't? Telling It Like It Is next, right here on Midpoint.